The most elegant discovery true friends make is that they can grow separately without growing apart. Well, this precept is truly obeyed by Silicon Valley tech tycoon Elon Musk and Russian President Vladimir Putin. They both might reside in two different nations, but Russia has a lot of development plans for Elon Musk and his companies. Well, do you want to know more about it? Stay tuned in the video. Welcome to Elon Musk Newest. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to never miss the newest update on SpaceX, Tesla, Starship, or anything related to Mr. Elon Musk. That being said, let's begin. First, let me start by telling you about the space exploration talks going on between Musk and Russia. Ties between SpaceX's Elon Musk and Russia's space chief, Dmitry Rogozin, transpired to be swinging from sparring about trampolines to discussing an invitation for tea. The two aerospace giants had a conversation over Twitter following an interview Rogozin gave for CNN about the future of the Russian space industry, during which Rogozin adored Musk for him being an organizer of the space industry and as an investor who is not afraid to take the risk. Rogozin, the director general of Russian space agency Roscosmos, said that millionaires in his own country prefer to invest more in yachts rather than in spaceships, and reflected admiration for the private United States space industry. Rogozin is involved with the United States' burgeoning space tourism industry, including Branson's Virgin Galactic and Bezos' Blue Origin. "I like what your people are doing. People spend their own money on things useful for overall society," Rogozin said. But Rogozin redeems his highest praise for SpaceX founder Elon Musk and condemns his own country's stagnation in space on the instability that followed the collapse of the Soviet Union. The space chief noted, "I already set the tea kettle on heat," urging Musk to later ask Rogozin on Twitter what the Russian chief likes to drink. Rogozin shared what he called his grandmother's favorite Indian tea, including a picture of the box. In Russian, the box advertises tea, Black Indian, from a brand called Three Elephants. He also said that Mr. Elon Musk realizes many of the ideas and thoughts that we wanted to realize but did not get to because after the breakup of the Soviet Union, our space program halted for some time, Rogozin said. "We respect him as an organizer of the space industry and as an investor who is not afraid to take risks." Roscosmos is now assembling a new type of rocket, named the Aimer, that was pioneered by SpaceX and Blue Origin. A reusable rocket, skilled at landing safely on Earth after launching its first stage into space. Rogozin wishes to have it ready to fly by 2025 and describes its resemblance to SpaceX's Falcon 9 rocket as normal, healthy competition between engineers. "This little project is just the opening and the day is not very far when these two big minds come together and create history in the field of space exploration." Well, this was all about SpaceX and Roscosmos, but Putin also aspires to stimulate the Tesla production in Russia. Addressing an event in Russia via video link, Musk said the company already has production sites in China and the United States, but is looking at opening production facilities in other parts of the world. Elon Musk said that Tesla is close to establishing a presence in Russia and is looking at whether it could unwrap new factories there. The Russian Ministry of Industry and Trade invited Musk to Russia. They said, "Dear Elon Musk, we were delighted to learn that you are considering building a factory in Russia. By the way, we have a number of state support measures for local OEMs, original equipment manufacturers. Come to see us. We'll talk about it," it said on social media. Tesla is presently working to set up its first gigafactory in Europe, which is placed in Germany. The facility, located near Berlin, is anticipated to be up and running in the next few weeks. But Musk has also hinted that the company seeks to set up its second facility in Asia after China. An ambiguous report referred to an appearance Musk made at the Novoye Znanye educational event in May, at which he said that Tesla is speculating Russia as a potential home for a new facility. "We have a factory in Shanghai. We are also building in Berlin, Texas, California, and we want to have factories in other parts of the world," the billionaire said. "We are potentially considering Russia." Barring a full-on gigafactory, Musk also said at the event that a Tesla representative office could open in Russia soon. Assertions of the week contended that governors from multiple Russian regions have been charming Musk with promises of land and special privileges. Russia has its own small private car maker, Zetta, which is developing an electric car and plans to launch production this year. The auto industry in Russia, a global oil and gas exporter, has no victorious electric car projects at present, and critics see slim chances in the near future, mainly due to poor charging infrastructure. Earlier in May 2021, Elon Musk had instructed the United States and the Russian government to hold talks to withstand refined ties post-Cold War lows. At a meeting on Russian education in Moscow, Musk was heard saying, "There is a lot of talent and energy in Russia, and I think there should be more dialogue and communication between Russia and the United States." He had also said, "I think we will soon be present in Russia. I think it will be amazing. We also need to look more broadly at Kazakhstan and other CIS countries. This is important to us. And this is not a decision taken while having a cup of tea. Musk plans to do business in Russia because the people out there seem to love Tesla. Tesla Motors had global earnings of $1.1 billion in the first quarter, the same amount Russians spent on luxury cars in January through May last year. Vratsky, a 33-year-old software executive, wanted to trade his BMW X6 for a $75,000 Tesla S so badly that he decided to pay almost double for it. With no sales network in Russia, he had to buy his sedan in the US and spend $12,000 to fly to Moscow, where it cost $50,000 to clear customs. When he first began driving his ocean blue Tesla a few years ago, Vratsky said he felt like an endangered lineage in the wild. Now he's drifting with dozens of other members of the fan club he commenced and has sighted about 250 more. "I love gadgets, and this thing is a pure gadget, like an iPhone on wheels," said Ivan Strashinsky, who oversees most of Alisher Usmanov's $14 billion fortune as head of USM Advisors. He bought a white Model S and is shopping for a red one too. Other Russian landlords include billionaire Roman Abramovich and bankers Herman Greff and Andrei Akimov, who head OEO Sberbank and OEO Gazprombank, Russia's largest and third largest lenders respectively. For Greff, not even the US-led sanctions that severed his bank from the global financial system can prevent his affection for the American machine. "It doesn't pollute nature, and it's super cheap and easy to use," Greff said by email. With such prominent buyers already happy in an affluent class famed for bouts of conspicuous consumption, Tesla could easily sell 2,000 Model S sedans and 2,000 of its upcoming Model X sport utility vehicles a year in Russia if it paid as much compassion to this country as it does to China. But months after Tesla's CEO went to Russia and announced that his company is scheming to set up an EV hub there, Elon Musk has withheld that the electric vehicle manufacturer has any blueprints to set up a facility there anytime soon. Tesla CEO Elon Musk took to Twitter to clear any doubts about it when he replied to one of the users seeking his reply on Tesla's Gigafactory plan for Russia. Musk replied, "Tesla has not yet decided on a fourth Gigafactory location, putting an end to any further beliefs." Elon Musk's refusal comes amid reports by a section of the Russian media that Tesla has approved to build a Gigafactory in the country. According to reports published in one of the Russian web outlets, Argumenti, the decision to set up a Gigafactory in Korolev, an industrial city near capital Moscow, was made at the Kremlin. Nowadays, Musk is busy with his Gigafactory in Berlin, but sooner or later he will tour Russia, and this time he will not go barehanded, but with plans for a new factory's launch. Well, apart from our expectations and thoughts, what do you think about the relations between Elon Musk and Russian President Vladimir Putin? Will their bond open new gates for Musk and companies to succeed in the forthcoming years? Let us know in the comments below. And most importantly, if you want to be updated on every single topic related to Elon Musk, then you should consider subscribing to the channel and pressing the bell icon. See you in the next one. Until then, peace.